Welcome back to another episode of Ask Matt. Today's question is from Gustavo Jordan, who says, "Hi, Matt. After I learned Laravel from your book, do you advise to learn Livewire or Plain View?" So what he's saying here is that the majority of people who are working in Laravel are working in some other front-end stack. And a lot of older projects are using jQuery and Angular and stuff like that. But the majority of projects today use Vue. Second after that would probably be React. Ember's pretty far down the list. And then there's these new projects, Livewire and Inertia and Alpine, that are getting some play. And so I did some YouTube videos that you can check out about converting novapackages.com, the homepage, from using Vue to using Livewire. And if you're not familiar with Livewire, there's a great video introducing it, but also you can go from the Laracon online videos, so go laracon.net for that. And Caleb Porzio, the founder of it, talked all about it and gave a really great intro at Laracon online. But you can also go to laravel-livewire.com to check it out and learn more about it. And the way it works is it's sort of like PJAX, or I don't know why I can never remember the name of the Rails project that does that, but where you got two server rendered requests, and let's say you're on the list items page, and you tap into an item, and instead of actually fully rendering the next page, it sends an AJAX request over to the next page, and the next page knows that this is through this thing called PJAX, and it only sends back just the portion of the page that changed. So Livewire is very similar to that, except it's much more intelligent in terms of how you're defining these components, whereas the PJAX and other systems like that, like the Rails one, which I can't remember the name of, you'll all tell me in the comments, I'm confident. They just kind of like look at the app boundary or something like that. And so they're kind of dumb in terms of the updates they're making. So Livewire is a lot more intelligent in terms of the changes it's making and the things that it's tracking. And so with Livewire, you define individual components and they have their own state, sort of like in Vue. So I could go way more into it. I'll probably do some introductory videos that are more intentional, not just live streams. But in general, this question he's asking here is, if I just finished learning Laravel, what do I learn? Do I learn Vue? Do I learn Livewire? My canonical response in the past has always been definitely learn Vue. There's a ton of people hiring for it. A lot of people are using it. It's really powerful and it's really well and healthily integrated into the Laravel world. However, I think that there's going to be a little bit of differentiation now as I think about that. Now, Inertia is something that plays really nicely on top of Vue and Laravel, or Vue and React. So you still need to learn one of the front-end frameworks. So Inertia is great, but you still need to use something else. Alpine is way too small to handle all your JavaScript stuff. It's very useful to learn. You should learn it. It's very quick and easy, but it's not a replacement for anything. But I think that the Vue versus Livewire is actually a really interesting conversation. So I would say, for starters, what are you trying to do? And this is what I said to his tweet. Are you trying to get a job? People are hiring for Vue. If you want to get a job, go do Vue. Are you trying to learn a front-end framework that's going to be flexible across all the other backends you work with? Go for Vue. Livewire is only for Laravel. However, are you a Laravel programmer who is trying to be able to do, you know, things like the page updates when you go get new data or new lists or change a certain component on the page, but it's not really massive changes. You're not doing single page apps. You just want things to be more responsive and things not have to refresh the whole page when you're changing out certain pieces of it. Or do you want certain pieces of it to update with pagination or with search results or something like that? If you want to do just that, and you're on your own, or you're at a small enough team where you can get buy-in for Livewire, or if you're watching this video a little bit later and Livewire has really picked up a little bit more, I think Livewire is great because the Livewire syntax is almost exactly the same as the Laravel syntax. And so for a Laravel developer to learn Livewire, it's going to be much simpler than for a Laravel developer to learn Vue. So that doesn't mean I'm saying all projects should switch from Vue to Livewire. I think there's good projects for one and good projects for the other. But to this specific question, should I learn Livewire or Vue if I just learn Laravel? I would say if you're in a context where you can use Livewire, which is not everybody and not every project and also not every developer or hiring situation, if you're in a project where you can use Livewire, I think it's going to be a much faster route from I know Laravel to I can make responsive front ends than it would for Vue. And so I think that's a really interesting place to be in because I've just said Vue for the longest time for everybody. I think this is inspiring to me to make an intro to Livewire video of my own, even though Caleb's was really great on the Laracon one. So maybe if you see this, you know, more than a couple days after I put this video out, you might see that I've got a video coming out. And if you haven't subscribed, go subscribe so you can see when it comes out, because I think I might make an intro to Livewire video. So hope this helps. Send me more questions. I'm on Twitter @StaufferMatt, or you can put them in the comments below. Thanks.